I should mention that as we were working on this tune, I said, boy, it sure would be nice and authentic to have brass bass on this one, you know? What can we do? And Logan gives me one of those looks and says, I was a band director. Okay, all right. So little did he know that I was going to program his lead chart right after the tuba. And by the way, watch out for next semester. He's going to play the piccolo obbligato on Stars and Stripes. This is this next tune is relatively new. This is a thing that was commissioned by the Iowa Jazz Educators Association for one of the all-state bands last year, the 182A band, and it's called Green Ladies, and if you've ever been over the Park Avenue Bridge in Waterloo, you know that high atop the YMCA, there are four really striking green statues of four ladies, and each one represents something or another. One represents commerce, and one of them represents agriculture. One of them, I think, represents crime, and the other one represents, I don't know. Anyway, there used to be six, and in typical Waterloo fashion, there are only four left. I can say that because I live in Waterloo. But they're striking. If you go across the bridge in the morning and they're all lit up, it's really striking. And the image has stayed with me, and I was thinking about that image as I was making this piece. And you're going to hear on this from Gerardo Gato Gomez on the tenor saxophone. And also from Marshall Egerton on the drums. This is Green Ladies.